There's a tremendous amount of computation that people want to use, and it's affecting our power grid. What would the government actually do about it? Like, would they just be like, okay, you got to relax on the computation, the AI workloads, or do you, or they start having like brownouts and rollouts of power? Like, I genuinely don't know.
Yeah, yeah, no. Ideally, we would not have brownouts and
brown, hoping, right?
Those are not good. There's a few different things or a few different ways I would think about that question. Think about what's going on right now in industry. So within the industry, you've got kind of a handful of firms here in the United States, all rushing to build as much computational capacity as they can. Now, this is because they're meeting emergent, immediate demand. It's because they're racing each other for market prominence. And then from, you know, our seat in Washington, it's also because we're competing internationally to be at the front of this, you know, revolutionary portion of the economy. If you are building a large data center in the United States, because our electricity grid doesn't have a lot of what we call spare capacity, meaning it's not like your house where you've got extra plugs going around the place. So when you get a new appliance, you can just bring it inside and plug it in. Our grid in the United States is relatively finely balanced and doesn't have a lot of sort of analogous open plugs. And so when you need to build what are now some of the largest new electricity loads we have in the United States, these sort of, let's call them gigawatt scale data centers, those are, you need to wait in line until the local power authority can confidently provide you the power, or you need to bring the power yourself. Because if they plugged in too early, you would get exactly the things that you mentioned. You might get grid instability. You might get just like rising prices because they had to bring electricity in from other regions. You get a lot of negative outcomes that neither the citizenry nor do I think the companies really want to cause.
How can infrastructure and operations be leveraged to mitigate this demand?
Think about what we need to achieve here. So over the next few years, because let's take the optimistic's case, let's build for optimism. We need to build really large data centers and probably a lot of them in the United States. Just as a like kind of baseline for your audience, a 1 gigawatt data center is like one of the largest electricity loads you have in the United States, right? That is a Hoover Dam worth of electricity. And you can't just build Hoover Dams, right? You have to build the whole system to meet that much load. In the context of, you know, building these large projects, you need to sort of finely match how much electricity generation you're bringing and the demand as the two rise together. And then what are the characteristics that you need to have? By and large, where we are today, because of the spare capacity issue, you need to bring as much new generation almost as you're adding load. There's some fine grade details on that statement and some power nerds will disagree, but that's why we have an open public dialogue. You want to be able to do that relatively quickly because of the sense of urgency around building these things, both in the United States and for market competition between firms. And you want to build it as cleanly as possible. So to achieve those three goals, there's a couple key places where the federal government can help with respect to infrastructure. One of them is just very large electricity transmission lines. It turns out when you're building large electricity loads, like these data centers are, and then you're connecting large new power plants, one of the things you need are not the small distribution scale power lines that go to homes and businesses that we are familiar with, but the mega transmission lines associated with moving power over long distances. Those are things that are approved by the federal government often if they cross state lines. There's sort of there's a detailed regulatory process that governs where they're built and how they're planned and all that kind of stuff. Accelerating that process, in my view, would be extremely helpful because one of the things we see in the empirical data of where data center developers are building, they're building the places where they can most readily attach themselves to high voltage or be in the vicinity of high voltage transmission lines. The second thing that the federal government can do, because the federal government plays such a significant role in the development, licensing, and approval of nuclear power plants. When we think about nuclear power, not really a solution that's speedy, but a solution that in our assessment we need for long-term sustainable growth of this industry and sort of energy security. It's a grid-improving technology, so sort of the energy security of the electricity system. The federal government, I think, plays a significant role there. The last thing I will say, and this is more on the private sector side, there's all sorts of emerging solutions around load flexibility, having data centers being a little bit more actively managed, so that of periods of time where other elements of the grid are drawing a lot of electricity, data centers can throttle down a little bit. Right now, most data centers run full bore all the time because the things that they do are highly economically productive and the owner spend a lot of money on those chips and they want to use them. But I suspect in the future, we'll see a lot more flexibility on the demand side so that the whole system can balance more efficiently. And that helps you address the need to match every new chip or every new data center with the equivalent of a new Hoover Dam.
So let's talk a little bit about the private sector side. As a business leader, how can you start reframing energy usage within your individual AI operation?
So I would look at it in two ways. One is all this energy use is delivering value. So as long as you're delivering the maximum amount of value you can, I don't think people should feel bad about using the energy, right? This is the natural byproduct of positive economic activity. That's great. I do think the private sector is going to play an instrumental role in making sure that as society goes through this transition, the power that we're using for AI data centers is clean, that we're making the right investments in nuclear. That involves firms making decisions, maybe taking some risks on new power sources, as well as making sure that our policymakers know how important it is that we have stable, inexpensive, and clean power.
It's really interesting to think that AI computation, all this big generative AI and AI agentic workloads for all these tremendous enterprises are actually going to push forward nuclear adoption in this country, because it feels like, when was the last time we built a nuclear power station?
We finished one last year or the year before, but it was the first one we'd built in decades. And so, yeah, you're starting to sense, we're not there yet, but you're starting to sense that there is a moment of opportunity here. And I have to say, we, for the last couple decades, our electricity system has been growing very, very slowly. And that was convenient, actually. It meant we could reduce greenhouse gas emissions by substituting out coal plants and bringing on a mixture of natural gas and renewables. Price management is relatively easier when demand is stagnant. And just that industry, its leadership is unfamiliar with rapid growth, except for a couple places in the United States like Texas. So it is the urgency of the AI data center issue and the sort of the need that it's placing on the power sector is causing the whole industry to look again at itself and say, how do we be more innovative? How do we capture more financing? How do we grow? And for all the other things we want to accomplish as a society, which will be AI enabled, but are not expressly AI, that's, taking a leadership stance in new chip manufacture or having a lot of electric vehicles, all that's going to rely on more electricity anyway. It's just that the AI revolution, in my view, is sort of the tip of the spear for the entire economic frontier being about electricity.
Well, I also think that because AI, at least the AI tools that we have, is so democratized that everybody has access to these incredible tools, that might push the needle quicker too, right?
Yeah, I think so. Both as a matter of demand and because you start looking at finding efficiencies throughout the economy, and AI is clearly going to enable people to find new and innovative ways both to use energy or deploy it.
So what do you find the most compelling about this intersection between AI and energy?
Currently for me, because I'm deeply embedded in public policy conversations, I'm excited about the forcing function that AI is placing on policymakers, whom your audience would not be surprised to know typically don't want to take a lot of risks, right? They don't always want to read our white papers and act on our suggestions. But the moment of urgency that we find ourselves in to make sure that the U.S. AI industry is allowed to grow as much as it needs to really creates a lot of public policy opportunity that I think is going to improve our ability to reduce electricity prices, reduce greenhouse gas emissions, and resolve a variety of other social ills.
And so this is, again, part of this idea of allowing the U.S. to be the leader in AI, right? And in order to do that, we need more power plants. We need more energy available for these giant data centers.
That's exactly right. But at the same time, or following on from that, we're going to need more electricity for electric vehicles.
Yeah.
Right. You're going to need more electricity for homes and businesses, and we're going to need more electricity to power all the economic growth that we expect to see from AI. And in that context, as a policy entrepreneur, the policy solutions that we can apply to help enable AI, in my view, enable all those other positive outcomes.